Are you encouraged by the Cleveland Browns' performance?
No, not at all. You know why? Because as far as I'm concerned, they had a bye week. The Jets are trash. Let's just call it what it is. My condolences to my brother Jeff Brown. Y'all know my boy Jeff out in Cali.
He's a Jets fan?
Diehard Jets
fan. Oh, because he's from New York originally.
Diehard Jets fan and subjecting my godson Nicholas to this atrocity year after year after year.
If you're a Jets fan, it's redundant to say diehard. If you're still alive and you're a Jets fan, you're obviously diehard.
That's a very, very good point. But listen, and I feel sorry. My sympathies go out to the Jets defense. It's not their fault. What can you do? You know how much time they spent on the field yesterday? I mean, they couldn't. The offense could do absolutely nothing. You had one player, Le'Veon Bell, and pretty much nothing else. You got no number one receiver. Nobody even looks like a number two receiver. You don't have a quarterback. Obviously, Sam Darnold is out with mono. Trevor Siemian looks like he broke his ankle, for crying out loud. He was out. You got this guy, Luke Falk, or whatever. I mean, I thought David Falk was the only Falk that I'd ever know. But we learned that there's another Falk that exists. It's Luke. I don't know whether there's relation there anything like that. But nevertheless, even though he didn't look bad, 20 or 25, 198 yards, you know, sacked twice, no touchdowns, no interceptions. The reality is the Jets don't have a quarterback. Mm-hmm. It's just that simple. Call Colin Kaepernick, but we'll get into that a little bit later on in the show. In the end, the defense was on the field entirely too much. And Odell Beckham Jr. was sensational. Mm-hmm. We get all of that, the one-handed catch, the electrifying touchdown, 89-yard touchdown scamper. We get all of that. But the Jets are not really a team. First of all, I've never been a fan of Adam Gase. All right, by the way, he gave them 3 points at the end of the first half. Because why don't you just run the ball, run out the clock, and run the hell into the locker room? What the hell are you doing throwing the football for? It's like the Atlanta Falcons did in the Super Bowl when all you got to do is run the ball, run out the clock, and New England won't have enough time to come back. But Quinn and Shanahan and those boys decided to throw the football, and New England ended up coming back and beating them. Obviously, this wasn't the Super Bowl because it's the Jets, who ain't been there since 1969. But in the end, when you look at it, let's understand that you've got Adam Gase, who I never believed should have been the head coach of this team, who hasn't been impressive as of yet, who highlighted why he wasn't impressive at the end of the first half when he gave the Browns an additional 3 points. And you have no offense whatsoever, okay? And so the way I look at it, Cleveland didn't prove much, but it ain't their fault. They weren't going up against an NFL team. They were going up against half a team. The Jets have a defense. I'm not putting it on their defense. I'm putting it on the fact that your offense is so inept that the defense just ran out of gas. They had no chance, no hope whatsoever. They knew it. They fought as best as they possibly could. But the Jets just are not an impressive team, period.
The Jets have a defense. So do the Browns. Miles Garrett's a bad dude.
Yes, he is.
And by the way, that's why I'm encouraged. Because if you look at the Browns, the offense was nothing to write home about. Odell was spectacular. Odell's from a different planet. He might be, you know, he or LeBron James or this. He's on a short list of greatest athletes on the planet. Baker Mayfield didn't look good. And he looked okay, you know. He was an NFL quarterback, but that's not good, Baker Mayfield. And, you know, last year, I gave a lot of credit to Kitchens, or Greg Williams at Kitchens, because when Hugh Jackson was gone, it was a tale of two seasons, not only for the team, but especially for the quarterback. Baker Mayfield went from a guy who had to thread the needle anytime he hit a receiver to a guy throwing to open receivers, which is the most important thing from the offensive coordinator, really. Are the receivers open? Mm-hmm. That's really the question. Mm-hmm. And Baker was sensational second half of the season. But maybe it wasn't just the coaching change. Maybe Baker's one of these guys that gets off the slow starts because he has not looked good so far this season. So the question for the offense is there reason to believe it will get better as time goes on? There's absolutely reason to believe. Zeitler, actually, remember the Zeitler for Vernon trade? Yep. Right? That was the first part of the Odell trade. When you take an excellent pass-blocking guard off your offensive line, it's going to take some weeks early in the season to get going. And I thought that might happen anyway, mm-hmm. right? So the O-line should improve as time goes on.
The Jets' offensive line.
No, I'm talking about Browns. Okay. Cleveland's offensive line should improve. Their offensive coordinator is now their head coach. So there should be open receivers eventually as this season progresses. Then the question is, what do they look like on the other side of the ball? If you believe in the offense, and I absolutely believe in their offense,
okay.
It's going to take some time to get going. Second half of the season, I think they're going to be devastating, and they'll get it together over the first half. The question is, what do they have defensively? Can they get to the quarterback? Yes, they can. This is a team with real talent on defense. So what I saw yesterday was obvious talent that we knew they had on both sides of the ball. And by the way, they have a brutal schedule coming up. They might be 2-4, 2-5, 3-4 after 7 games. But I think they're going to get white hot in the second half of the season.
Yeah, but I'm just saying that we didn't learn anything from playing the Jets. That's all I'm trying to say. We didn't learn anything. I understand what you're talking about, because if the Jets have a decent defense, then anything that you saw from Cleveland's offense, I get it. My point is, you know what? You can win games because of talent, and then you can win games because of attrition. And the fact is, and a demoralizing emotional level of attrition as well. It's not just physical. When you go out onto a football field and you know that you're working with your hands behind your back from opening tip-off, that's daunting enough. But then when the backup goes down and he's out, and even you as a teammate never heard of your quarterback, you know it gets bad. And that's what we're looking at here with the New York Jets. And then when you look at the coach itself, again, first of all, you knew it was bad from opening tap when he had his press conference and he showed up looking high. That's right. I'm going to keep reminding everybody. He looked high.
It was a little bug-eyed. I'm not sure of the cause.
I don't know if it was the weed or anything like that, but damn it, it's fair to say it's on camera. Anybody that doubts me, just look on camera. It's right there for everybody to see, Max. He looked high, okay? And damn it, he ain't coached much better since he's been here. You don't really have much to work with. He's got something to do with that. McCagnan's gone now, okay? You got the GM you wanted. You're the coach you want it to be, where you want it to be, etc. But when you look at it, it's Le'Veon Bell and pretty much nothing else without Sam Darnold. And that's what you're looking at.
Look,
here.
There's no doubt when you see a team beat the Jets, the Giants, either New York team or the Dolphins, it's like, well, what can you really tell about that? That's a gimme, right?
That's all I'm trying
to say. But this schedule, okay, good. We got it up. No, that's the New York Jets. Forget the Jets.
Let's look at the Browns schedule.
This is brutal.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For more sports highlights and analysis, be sure to download the ESPN app. And for live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.